One of the wisdoms of the past is رب عمل صغير تعظمه النية ورب عمل كبير تقله النية. That perhaps you do a small act, but it's sincere, and you find that it is great in reward. And perhaps you do something which is great, but you're not sincere, and so you won't find any reward in it. And I remind you also, be consistent with regards to your acts of worship. In the hadith found in Bukhari, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was asked about which deed is the deed which is most beloved to Allah, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the one that is continuous, even if it may be in small amounts. I remind you to seek knowledge. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, he who treads the path in search for knowledge, Allah will make the path that leads to paradise easy. Picture yourself in Jannah, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. An eternal life. No fear of death. Safe from getting older. There's no sickness. No disease. No plagues. No sadness, anxiety, depression. You don't have to take pills. You don't have to go to psychiatrist or psychologist. There's no gossip. There's no backbiting. There's no slander. No vain talk. Imagine yourself in Jannah. In its cool shade. Water springs around you, fruits at arm's reach, whether you are standing, whether you are sitting, whether you are on your side. Imagine how glad you will be in Jannah. Glad that you possess the right aqidah. Glad that you were a Muslim in the dunya. Glad that you woke up those cold mornings for Fajr. Glad that you didn't allow laziness to stand between you and the five prayers. Glad that you fasted those long daylight saving days in Ramadan. Glad, dear sister in Islam, you wore the hijab all those hot and sticky summer days. Glad that you adhered to the correct Islamic dress code. Picture your faces in Jannah, shining with joy, because you raised your children according to the Quran and the Sunnah, because you didn't allow yourself to be hoodwinked by Shaitan and his agents into riba, into illicit relationships and drugs, because you kept away from major sins. Imagine, my dear brothers and sisters, what it will be like to enter Jannah and actually meet the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his angels, and meet the angels and meet the Prophet and meet the companions, to meet Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman and Ali. Imagine how glad you'll be, but imagine too how glad they will be to see you, to see a generation that came after them, that believed in the message of the Quran, that believed in the message of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, despite never having seen the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, despite not having lived during the 23 years of the revelation of the Quran, despite believing in the miracles of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam without having seen them, believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without seeing him. And don't be duped by the Western world and by the media, by those who don't carry the correct belief, into thinking that real happiness is in this life. For in the hadith which is found in Muslim, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentions to us that a person who is destined to the hellfire, the one who had a life of ease and plenty, who had a life of affluence, he will be made to dip once into the hellfire, and he will be taken out, and it will be said to him, O son of Adam, have you found any comfort? Do you recall any comfort? Did you happen to get any material blessing? He will say, no, by Allah. He would have forgotten all the good. And then a person who is destined to Jannah, who had a miserable life, who had it hard, who was poverty, who was impoverished, and he will be made to dip once in the Jannah, and it will be said to him, O son of Adam, have you ever faced any distress or hardship? And he will say, no, by Allah, I never faced any experience, I'd never experienced hardships or distress. Let me conclude, inshallah ta'ala, with a short story. Jannah is the retirement package that you contributed to in this dunya. Jannah is the fruit of the seeds planted in the dunya. There once was a pious man, and he was enslaved to a wicked master. And the righteous slave wanted to teach his master a lesson that he would never forget, a lesson that would make him change his evil habits and ways. So the master one day told him to plant some wheat. So the slave took the opportunity. He went and he collected some seeds of barley and he planted them. So when the season drew near, the master was enraged to see that after all this work and time, the slave had planted the wrong seeds. So he became outraged and he said to him, "Why did you do this?" And the righteous slave said, "I had hope that the barley seeds would come out as wheat." So the master said, "How can you plant barley seeds and expect it to come out as wheat?" So the slave said to his master, "How can you disobey Allah and expect for His bounteous mercy? How can you openly challenge His deen and hope for Jannah?" He silenced his master with these few words. And so his master said to him, "You have taught me something today that I have never realized. You are free for the sake of Allah." My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, these are the words that I leave you with. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلني وإياكم من أهل الجنة. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين.